Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up Home Assistant OS on your Raspberry Pi. Home Assistant OS is a free and powerful software that allows you to easily set up home automation. It serves as a hub where all your devices can connect into and then you can automate them to perform certain tasks. Thanks to its large development community, Home Assistant has support for a huge range of smart devices. One of the great things about Home Assistant is that it has been optimized enough that it can run incredibly well on the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi makes a fantastic place to run Home Assistant because it is a very low powered device. This allows you to keep it running 24/7 without breaking the bank account. For this, we highly recommend that you use one of the newer Raspberry Pis. The more performance your Raspberry Pi has available, the better experience you will have with Home Assistant. Before we get started, the one thing you will need to have is an Ethernet connection to your Raspberry Pi. While it is technically possible to set up a Wi-Fi connection, it is not recommended and is not something we will be covering in this guide. Home automation is something that really requires good reliability, which is not something that's afforded by all Wi-Fi connections. To install Home Assistant OS to your Raspberry Pi, we will be making use of the software called Raspberry Pi Imager. This is one of the best ways to write operating systems via your SD card, USB drive or NVMe drive. If you don't have this installed, you can get it from the official Raspberry Pi website. We'll leave a link to this below. Once you have the imager installed, open up and then click the Choose Device button. Here you'll see a list of the different Raspberry Pis. Select the model that you intend on using. In our case, this is the Raspberry Pi 5. Selecting your model helps the imager only show compatible operating systems. Next, you'll want to click the Choose OS button. Now scroll down until you see the section labeled Other Specific Purpose OS and click it. Next, click the Home Assistance and Home Automation option. Now click Home Assistant. And finally, click the option labeled Home Assistant OS. Next, we must select the storage device to write this operating system to. To do this, click the Choose Storage button. On this screen, you'll see a list of available storage devices that the imager can write to. Select the one that you plan on using with your Raspberry Pi. Ensure that all three options have been set correctly and then click the Next button. You'll see a warning about how all existing data on this device will be erased. If you're happy with this, click the Yes button to continue. The imager will now download the latest version of Home Assistant OS and save it to your chosen storage device. If everything has worked correctly, you'll see a message now telling you that Home Assistant OS has been written to your chosen storage device. You can now remove the SD card from your reader and plug it into your Raspberry Pi and then power the Raspberry Pi on. Once Home Assistant OS is started up, if you have a monitor attached, you'll be able to see certain information such as the IP addresses that have been assigned to your Raspberry Pi. At this point, you'll want to ensure that your Home Assistant installation has a static IP address. The best way to do this is through DHCP reservation on your router. This will ensure that your Raspberry Pi is assigned the same IP address every time it connects to your network. If you set a static IP address using your router, you can then skip to accessing Home Assistant through your web browser. The other solution is to set a static IP address on your machine itself. There are downsides to this, however. There is no guarantee your router will honor this request, which will lead to connection issues. For these next steps, you will need a keyboard and a monitor attached to your Raspberry Pi. Once you're ready, change from the Home Assistant command line to the normal bash by typing in login. Now we can begin to edit the default connection by typing in nmcli space con space edit space double quote supervisor space end 0 double quote and then pressing enter. Now that we are editing the default connection for our Home Assistant installation, we can set a static IP address by typing in set space ipv4.addresses space followed by the IP address that you want to assign your Raspberry Pi and then slash 24 and then press enter. If prompted, if you want to also set the IPv4 method to manual, type yes and press enter. With the DHCP lookup now disabled, we must also set the DNS and gateway. First, set the DNS by typing in set space ipv4.dns space followed by the IP address of a DNS server. Often you can just use the same IP address as your router, which in our case we will be, which will be 192.168.0.1. Next, set the gateway IP address by typing in set space ipv4.gateway space followed by the IP address of your router. In many cases, this will be 192.168.0.1. With this now all set, we can save these changes by simply typing in save and pressing enter. With a static IP now requested, we can quit out of this tool by typing in quit. Now to ensure that your static IP address is actually being assigned, reboot your Raspberry Pi by typing in reboot and pressing enter. If everything has worked correctly, you should now see your IPv4 address is the same as the static one that you set within the config earlier. At this point, we can now go and connect to the Home Assistant web interface. To access the Home Assistant web interface, you'll want to open up your favorite web browser and then go to http://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, then colon, and then the port 8123. It is also possible to use homeassistant.local:8123 in place of your Raspberry Pi's IP address. The first time you access your Raspberry Pi's Home Assistant installation, you will need to go through some initial setup steps. To begin this process, click the Create My Smart Home button. Now on here, give yourself a name and a username and then a password for your account. Ensure that you set a secure password as this user will have full control over Home Assistant. Once you have everything set, click the Create Account button. This next step will allow you to set your home location. This is used for proximity-based automations within Home Assistant as well as getting information such as your local weather. Once you have set your address, click the Next button. Home Assistant will now ask if you want to provide them with any analytics. You don't have to, so you can either toggle these on or off and then click the Next button to proceed. Home Assistant will now list any devices that it has automatically found on your network. All of these devices are compatible out of the box and don't require additional configuration. To complete the initial setup of Home Assistant OS on your Raspberry Pi, click the Finish button. With that done, you have now successfully got Home Assistant OS up and running on your Raspberry Pi. You can now begin using it to automate things around your home and gathering data from a variety of different sensors. Now, not everything is supported by Home Assistant out of the box. Some rely on third-party integrations. To make setting up these integrations a bit easier on you later on, we will show you the steps to installing HACS. HACS stands for Home Assistant Community Store and is one of the best ways to install custom integrations that aren't officially included within Home Assistant. To set up this store, click Settings in the sidebar and then click the Add-ons option. On this page, you'll want to click the Add-on Store button in the bottom right corner. Next, click the three dots in the top right corner and then click the Repositories option. In here, you'll want to type in https://github.com/hacks/addons and then click the Add button. Once you can see HACS listed here, click the Close button and then refresh the page by hitting F5. Now use the search bar at the top to type in HACS and then click the Get HACS option. On this page, click the Install button. This will install an add-on that makes installing HACS a really simple process. With the Get HACS add-on now installed, click the Start button and then switch to the Log tab. Once HACS has been installed to your Raspberry Pi Home Assistant installation, you should see the message, Installation Complete. Before HACS shows up within your Home Assistant installation, you will need to reboot your device. To do this, change to the Developer Tools page using the sidebar and then click the Restart button and then click Restart Home Assistant and then click Restart again. Once Home Assistant finishes restarting, we will now need to change back to the Settings screen and then this time click the Devices and Services option. On this page, click the Add Integration button in the bottom right corner and then search for HACS. Once you see HACS appear, click it and then read and check each of the checkboxes. Once you are happy to proceed with the installation of HACS, click the Submit button. For HACS to be able to function properly, it will need access to a GitHub account. Click the link provided and then follow the steps to authorize HACS with your GitHub account. To authorize HACS, you will need to use the code that is currently displayed on your screen. If everything has worked properly, you should see a success message appear on your screen. You can now just click the Finish button to return back to Home Assistant. If everything has worked properly, you should see HACS listed in the sidebar. You will now see a huge number of different integrations that you can easily install to your system. This significantly increases the amount of devices that your Home Assistant installation can talk with, while also giving you more elements that you can use within the dashboard system. At this point, you should hopefully have Home Assistant up and running on your Raspberry Pi. If you have found this guide to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.